Hello. In this video, I'm going to give you a quick introduction to using computer control in Grid 3. Computer control is a special kind of grid set that allows you to use Grid to control other Windows applications using your standard access method, for example, eye gaze or a head mouse. So first of all, we just need to choose whether we prefer a horizontal or vertical layout. Going to choose horizontal. So here we have the basic grid, which allows you to click your mouse and to type. So I'm going to open up the calculator app by selecting left click and then moving my pointer down to the taskbar, dwelling on calculator. And that's opened that up for me. Now I'm going to open up the keyboard. And you can see that at the moment that's kind of in the way of the calculator. So I'm going to move it down to the bottom, like so. And move to numbers. And now I can do my calculation. I just want to choose the left click here. And choose multiply. There we go. And I can left click again to close the app and then exit typing. So we've been using the left mouse click button, and that's what you use most commonly. But if you need right click or double click, you'll find those on the clicks grid here. And you can also click and drag and so on as well. So, as well as this basic grid, we have some other grids that you might want to open if you're doing specific tasks. So, we're going to be doing something in the web browser next. So, if I open this up and then go to web. You can see that the cells on the left-hand side always stay the same, but the ones on the right change depending on the task that you're doing. So I'm going to launch my web browser. And I'm just going to move grid back down to the bottom so that I can see the address bar and so on here. So I want to open up the SmartBox web page, and I've got that saved in my favorites. So I'll select left click, then dwell on the favorites icon. Okay, now the web page is open, what I'm most likely to want to do is to scroll down the page. So I can actually open up a special grid for scrolling here. First of all, I need to just choose how fast I want to scroll. I choose medium. Once I've done that, all I have to do is move the mouse pointer onto the web page itself, and that will just steadily scroll until I just move the pointer quickly back to that same cell. As well as web browsing, we also have a special grid for office applications, which I'm going to open now. Again, we go to More and then Office. And I'm going to launch Microsoft Word. And I'll start by typing some text. You can see that I can use word prediction to speed things up. Sometimes the keyboard may be a little bit big and might get in the way of the thing you're trying to type into. There's a couple of solutions to that. You can temporarily make the grid a bit smaller. If you can access those smaller cells, then that might be the answer. But the other thing you can do is leave the cells the same size. You can switch to the minimal keyboard, which just removes the extra row at the top with the prediction cells and gives you a little bit more room to type. See, we also have emojis in the keyboard. We'll put a little smiley face in there. Now I've got some text. I can use this grid to save my document, to print it, and so on. And I can also adjust the size and style of the font as well. So if I choose select all, and then I'm going to make this bold, and then I'm going to make it a little bit bigger. And then I could save my document or print it out or whatever I need to do. So now I'll close this grid and exit computer control to take me back to Grid Explorer. I hope that introduction to computer control is helpful. Thank you for watching.